Pitao bih vas na početku jedno pitanje.
I'd like to ask you right at the start a question.
Da li je teško živjeti u ovo vreme kada je ovako bolest oko nas?
Is it difficult to live at this time of Earth's history with this illness around us?
Da li vam je teško što ljudi u svoje kuće što ste zatvoreni?
Is it difficult for you that you are restricted to being inside your home?
Sinoć na omladinskom času jedna osoba je rekla, tako mi nedostaje crkva.
Last night when we had the youth meeting, one person said, I so miss the church.
Vi znate da naši lovinci nisu do sve emotivni kada je crkva u pitanju, ali sinoć je tu bilo toliko emocije.
And you may think that youth is not that emotional, but last night we had a lot of emotion in this life.
Da li ima nada da će biti bolje?
Is there hope that it will be better?
Kakvi smo mi to ljudi ako mislimo da neće biti bolje?
What kind of people are we if we don't think it's going to be better?
Kakvi smo mi to vernici ako mislimo da neće biti bolje?
What kind of believers are we if we don't believe that it will be better?
Jedan pastor iz mog detinjstva, kad god bi se ga pitali kako si, on bi kazao, bit će bolje kad Gospod dođe.
One pastor from my childhood, whenever he would be asked, how are you? He said, it will be better when the Lord returns.
I to je u principu prično tačno ide.
And that's probably a very correct saying.
Međutim, šta nas čeka ovdje na zemlji dok on ne dođe?
Well, nevertheless, what's waiting for us on this earth before Jesus comes?
Da li je tačna ta uzrečica koju koristimo kada kažemo kako si, pa dobro sam, kako će mi, bit će dobro?
So, do we go along with that saying, so how are you, and you say, well, it'll be better?
Ova zemlja do sada vidjela je zaista puno zla.
This land has seen a lot of evil.
Od prvoga dana ovoga sveta, od početka naše civilizacije pa do danas, mnogo zla se dogodilo.
From the very first day of this earth and from civilization, there's been a lot of evil that has taken place.
Protav je radio prilično verno i vredno na tome da Bogu što bolje naprkosti tako što će njegovoj djeci načiniti što više zla.
And Satan has been hard at work to get at God to make, by making it more and more difficult for his own children.
Svađa i ubistva između Kajina i Avelja.
The anger and the killing of Abel by Cain.
Potop kao posljedica greha koji je potopio negdje više od 7 milijardi ljudi.
The flood which took away due to the evil of the world nearly 7 billion people.
Ratovi zverstva kroz cijel stari zavet koji su samo jedna strana istorije.
And all the wars of faith which are only one side of history.
Od Hristova do danas možemo da kažemo da je bilo puno ratova, puno genocida, puno nacionalnih netrpeljivosti.
And from Christ down to this day we can say that there has been a lot of killing, a lot of genocide and a lot of evil things happening to this day.
I to je samo jedna strana nesreće koju znamo.
And that's only one side of this unfortunate development we know.
Sa druge strane imamo prirodne katastrofe kao što su tsunami, zemljotresi, poplave.
We have natural disasters on the other hand, which are like earthquakes and floods and so on.
Nacionalne katastrofe kao što je bila ova eksplozija u Beirutu ili Hiroshima, Nagasaki.
National disasters such as we just had in Beirut or Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Ne znam da li ste vidjeli na vestima ili na Instagramu, na Facebooku snimak na YouTubeu kako izgleda eksplozija takve jedne moćne bombe.
I don't know whether you got to see on social media what that kind of an explosion looks like.
Puno ljudi koje je zatražilo da im se staklo izvadi iz tela zbog eksplozije svih tih stakala koje su bile razbijene.
There's many people who are asking for glass to be taken out from their bodies that this explosion put into them exploded all the windows.
Pored tih nekih eksplozija koje se dešavaju, također imamo mnogo nesreće po pitanju pedofilije, krađe dece, seksualnog zlostavljanja, mentalnog zlostavljanja.
And besides these kind of events, we have to deal with issues such as pedophilia and child abuse and all sorts of demonic behavior with people.
Zemlja teško da može reći da izdrži svo ovo zlo koje se dešava na njoj.
The earth can hardly handle all the evil that is taking place upon.
Da li nam budućnost na ovoj zemlji zaista donosi nešto bolje?
Does the future on this earth really bring us something better?
Ako ne, šta bismo trebali da uradimo?
And if not, what should we do?
Kako da se postavimo?
How should we form ourselves?
Hajde da otvorimo najpoznatije poglavlje vezano za poslednje dane, pa da vidimo šta je Isus imao da kaže za te poslednje dane.
Let's open up the Bible to the most famous chapter which Jesus himself talks about these end days.
To je Matej 24. poglavlje.
That would be Matthew chapter 24.
Ja bih danas volao akcent da stavim na 9. stih.
And I'd like to highlight verse 9.
A stih 9 kaže ovako. Tada će vas predati na muke i pobiće vas i svi će narodi omrznuti na vas imena mojega radi.
And it says, then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake.
Vidimo da će biti muka, da će biti čak i smrti, da će mnogi omrznuti na nas zbog Hrista.
We see that there is going to be affliction, to even death for the name of Christ.
Također čitajući ovo poglavlje vidimo da će mnoga različita zla zadesiti našu planetu.
And reading this chapter, we can see that there is a lot of evil that will come upon this earth.
Ozbiljne, ozbiljne smrtonosne bolesti.
Real, serious, death-bringing illnesses.
Nesreće kakav ovaj svet još nije imao prilike da vidi.
The things that this world has not seen before.
Iako smo, kao što sam malo pre naglasio, videli mnoga različita zla.
And even though, as I said earlier, we have seen a lot of evil beforehand.
Ceo svet će biti upućen na svetkovanje prvog dana sedmice nedelje.
The whole world will be brought to worship the first day of the week, Sunday.
Zla će postati toliko velika da će se tražiti uzrok ko je kriv za ovoliko zla na zemlji.
The evil will be so rampant and so widespread that they will be asking and searching who is guilty for this disaster they're experiencing.
Sada vas pitam, ako za ovo vreme korone, već su ljudi na nekako na ivici da bi već čekali da prođe i kad bi znali ko je krivac, sigurno bi ga se rešili. Šta će biti kada veliko zlo dođe?
And if we are looking at this coronavirus situation, thinking that this is some kind of a grand situation where people are failing and not able to handle the situation now, what are we going to be like when the real trouble comes?
Vrlo lako će svo zlo prepisati na one koji nisu jedini za svetku i nedelju, nego oni koji svetkuju sedmi dan subotu.
Very easily the blame will be shifted to those who do not worship the first day Sunday, but worship the seventh day Sabbath.
Budući da su pod velikim pritiskom, šta mislite, koliko će im vremena trebati da se organizuju, da se reše oni koji kvara mir u svetu?
Because they are in great pressure to act quickly, how long do you think it would take them to get rid of those who are in their way and causing this damage?
Isus nabrajajući različito zla koja će se dogoditi i sve što će biti do njegovog dolaska, jednom u 24. poglavlju kaže nego.
And Jesus, as he's talking about the events that will come upon the planet, in the 24th chapter, he says in one verse, but.
I ako pogledamo, to je stih 20 i on kaže upravo ovako.
That's verse 20 and it says the following.
Nego se molite Bogu da ne bude bežan vaša u zimu ni u subotu.
And Jesus says, but pray ye that your flight not be in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day.
I 21. stih kaže, jer će biti nevolja velika, kakva nije bila po stanju sveta, do sada niti će biti.
And verse 21 says, for then shall be great tribulation such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be.
22. kaže, i da se oni dani ne skrate, niko ne bi ostao, ali izvedeni kradi, skratit će se dani oni.
And verse 22 says, and except those days shall be shortened, there shall no flesh be saved, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened.
Zaista, bit će vreme kako nikada nije bilo, i skratit će nas oni koji su izabrani.
And really, the time coming is such as never was before, and it will be shortened for the elect's sake.
Podelio bih sa vama sad jedan citat iz knjige događaja i posljednjih dana sa 204. i 205. strane.
I'd like to share a quote from the book Last Day Events from pages 204 and 205.
Kaže, crkva ostatka bit će izložena velikim nevoljama i kušanjima.
And it says that the remnant church will be exposed to great tribulations in those times.
Oni koji budu držali Božje zapovesti i imali veru Isusovu,
the ones who hold, have the commandments of God and have the faith of Jesus,
osjetit će gnev Azake i njenih sledbenika.
They will feel the fierceness of the dragon and those who follow him.
Satana ljude u svetu smatra svojim podanicima.
Satan looks upon people on this earth as his own possession.
On je postigao kontrolu nad ostalim crkvama.
He's gained control on the fallen churches.
No, sada se pojavljuje mala četa koja se odupire njegovoj pravosti.
But there's a little group that is appearing that's opposing him.
Te kada bih uspio da izbrise sa zemlje,
and if he could just wipe him off the face of the earth,
njegova pobjeda bila bi potpuna.
His victory would be complete.
I kao se uticao na nezabožetske narode, da uništavaju Izrael.
And as he affected the heathen people to destroy Israel,
tako će u skoroj budućnosti pokrenuti bezbožne sile na zemlji da unište Božji narod.
And he will do the same to muster up the forces of this earth to destroy God's children.
Citat u nastavku kaže da će se sa raznih i sa mnogih poznatih crkava odjekivati, odnosno propovedonica, odjekivati glas kako bi trebalo da se kaze oni koji ne postaju na ljudi.
And we are told in another quote that there will be those who will bring forth voices from the pulpits saying that those who are opposing our decrees and demands should be eliminated.
Govori se o tome da ta manjina koja se protivi tom velikom ujedinjenju celoga sveta ne treba više da se trpi, da se eliminira.
And they will be saying that this little group that does not want to conform to the whole world needs to be eradicated and eliminated.
I da je puno bolje da strada manjina nego da ceo svet trpi zbog toga.
And it's much better that a small group suffer rather than the whole world suffering the events.
Da čitav svet ne bi trpeo principu pometnju i bezakonju.
That the whole world would not live in this confusion and lawlessness.
I sa istim razlogom su se i pred 20 vekova poslužili protiv Hrista upravitelji naroda.
And the same ways and methods were utilized 20 centuries ago to go against the people of God.
Taj razlog će izgledati najubedljiviji, kaže ovaj citat.
And that reasoning will be the most forthright for them.
Iako neko i dalje misli da je situacija u kojoj se mi nalazimo jako strašna i jako teška, čitajući ovo, Biblija kaže da je to samo senka onoga što će u stvari doći.
And looking at the events that we are talking about right now, the Bible tells us that this is just a foreshadow of the things to come.
Stvari koje dolaze će biti puno ozbiljnije, a ajde da pročitamo sada iz Jeremije, iz osmog poglavlja, stihove koje će nam danas biti jako značajni.
The events that are coming are going to be far more serious. So let us look at the book of Jeremiah and the 8th chapter.
Čitit ćemo kraj 10. stiha i 11.
We'll read the end of verse 10 and verse 11.
Kaže, i proroci, i sveštenici, svi su varali se, jer leče rane kćeri naroda mojega, oblač govoreći, mir je, mir je, a mira nema.
Second part of verse 10, for everyone from the least even unto the greatest is given to covetousness. From the prophet even unto the priest, everyone dealeth falsely. For they that feel the hurt of the daughter of my people slightly, saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace.
Govor o imaginarnom miru, kojeg realno u svetu nema, nije na korist, ni svetu, ni vjernicima.
The imagined peace which is being talked about is not for the good of the believers, nor for the whole world.
Govor o boljoj, bliskoj budućnosti je biblijski neosnovan.
The talk of a better future, near future, is not based on the Bible.
И не на корысть, не на спасение никому.
And it's not for the salvation of anybody.
Пишу ли вам пример из опера Ценесала, у кои е радио мой брат, скажем?
I'd like to tell you a story of an operational room where my brother was working.
То се десило пред 2.5 години в Лондоне.
This took place 2.5 years ago in London.
И мой брат Дарий ми прича, каже, дошло е еден човек, тако, близо 60 година, пуне снази, spreman da radi.
And he told me about a man, about 60 years old, full of strength and ready to work, he came along.
Imao je problem sa bruhom, došlo je da operiše bruh.
He came to have an operation on the stomach lining.
Bezazljena operacija, tako ništa što je komplikovano i što je jednostavno pidesno.
Nothing complicated as far as operations go.
I kad se probudio, očekivao je doktor da mu kaže kad može da napusti bolnicu i da ode kući.
And when he woke from the sedation, he was expecting the doctor to tell him when he can go home from the hospital.
On je već imao kartu za Ameriku, morao je za nedelju dana već da bude u Americi, imao je različite stvari koje trebao tamo da obavi.
He had a booked ticket to fly to America in a week's time, and he had reasons that he needed to go there.
I pitao doktore, kad mogu da idem?
And he asked the doctor, when can I go?
Doktor kaže, izvini, moramo nešto ti kažemo, jako je važno.
But the doctor said, look, we need to tell you something that's very important.
Nisi do sada imao simptome, ali kada smo otvorili stomak, vidjeli smo ozbiljan kancer na tvojim crevima.
He said, you didn't have any symptoms, but when we open up your stomach, we noticed that there was a big cancer developing.
Ali ja moram da putujem za Ameriku za 7 dana.
But I need to go to America in 7 days' time.
Nema Amerike, nikakve ostaje tu.
No America for you, you're going to be staying here.
Ali, tako ti ja i posle te Amerike imam planove, imam puno stvari da obavim.
Look, I even after this America, I've got a lot of plans, I need to do a lot of things.
Doktor je morao da bude real, on je rekao ovako, ako hoćeš da živiš, moraš ostati ovde i moramo uložiti ozbiljan napor i pitanje da ćeš se izlečiti.
And the doctor being a realist, he said, look, if you want to live, you have to stay here and we have to invest a lot of effort to look after your illness.
Mogu je doktor i ovako da kaže.
The doctor could have studied this way too.
Mogu je da kaže, pa dobro, idi ti, nema veze, pa šta, jednom ste živi.
He could have said, but look, okay, you go, you live once, go and do what you need.
Da je neki zdrav doktor, mogu i ništa da mu ne kaže.
If he was some evil doctor, he probably wouldn't even need to say anything to him.
Pitanje je, da li bi to tom čovjeku donilo neko dobro to što bi sakrivali od njega da ima rak?
And question, would that be good for this man if they were to hide the fact that he had cancer?
Da li je dobro ili kad se dogodi negdje našte u kojima neko dobije rak, i cijela porodica se zdala nekako nađe neki prirodni lek, bilo šta da pomogne tom čovjeku.
And even within our own families, when the stomach who has cancer, we do everything to find some natural herb, a remedy to heal this cancer.
Upravo opasno za zdravlje tog bolesnog je sakrivati od njega pravu sliku stvari.
The very evil thing is to hide the truth from that person.
Mislim da je za naše stanje, za tvoje duhovno stanje, danas opasno kazati da je mir.
And it's very difficult and dangerous for your own spiritual well-being to say that today is okay.
Opasno je kazati, pa biće dobro.
It's very dangerous to say, it'll be right, she'll be right.
Dragi moji, stičem utisak da je jedino ispravno reći, kao što je pastor iz Moga Tilipa govorio, biće bolje kad Gospod dođe.
I think the only true way and the right way to speak is, as my pastor from my childhood said, it'll be good when the Jesus returns.
Naše duhovno stanje možda ima rak.
Maybe our spiritual condition has a cancer.
Možda treba kazati da našem duhovnom stanju treba pomoć.
Maybe it needs to be told to our spiritual well-being that it has a problem that needs helping.
Uspavani smo od narkoze koju Satana stavlja sa svih strana u naš život.
We've been put to sleep by the medicines that Satan is placing upon people from all different angles on this planet.
Uspavali smo kompromise kao što smo ranije slušali.
And we have been put to sleep through compromises we listened to earlier.
mogu vam kazati da ova bolest koja se nalazi oko nas može će baš biti na spasenju mnogima.
But I have to say that this illness which is found around us may be to the salvation of many.
Sigurno sam da će neki ovu situaciju iskoristiti na svoje duhovno potrebe i vidio sam tako i drago mi zbog toga.
I'm sure that people will use this difficult circumstance we are in to allow God to transform their spiritual life. And I've seen it and witnessed it myself.
Jer dolazi nevolja koja će sve što je mlako, poluobraćeno pa neobraćeno, čak možda i izabrane, pokušati da odvoji od Boga.
And there's a trial which is coming, which may be on those who are believers, maybe those who have been elected, maybe those who are slightly on the edge, not knowing what to go and what to believe, or be all try to sweep them all away.
Trenutno mogu bi da kažem da jako dobro živim.
I say at the moment we are living very well.
Programi se rade, hranu možemo još uvek da kupimo, hrane imamo, goriva možemo da kupimo, da se vozimo i dalje, stvari funkcionišu.
We have shops that are operating, we can buy food, we can buy petrol, the cars are going, things are pretty normal still.
Zalike možemo da stvorimo i dalje.
We can put certain things away for the future if we want.
Bogosluženje na verskoj osnovi dalje teče neometano.
The worship services are continuing to function without any obstacles.
Milost je uvek traje, možemo dobimo pokajanje.
God's mercy is still there and grace, we can still ask for its forgiveness.
Ali nećemo činiti nikome uslugu ako kažemo mir je i bit će dobro, jer time nikome u suštini ne činimo dobro.
But if we go and say peace and safety to others around us and it's going to be good, we're not doing anybody's service.
Hajde da vidimo kako su prošli oni koji su govorili mir je, a mira nije bilo.
Let's see how those who spoke peace, peace, and there was no peace, how they went.
20. stih istog poglavlja kaže, zetva je prošla, ljeto minulo, a mi se ne izbavili.
And in the 20th verse of chapter 8 of Jeremiah it says, the harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved.
U poslednje vreme, i što budemo bliži ka poslednjem vremenu, sve će se više izdvajati samo dve grupe.
In this last days that we are living in, and closer that we come to that last day, there's going to be a greater division of two groups.
Prva grupa koja će imati realnu sliku o svoje grešnosti, o svoje nedostojnosti i koja će vapiti ka svome spasitelju.
The first group, which will have a realistic view of its own spiritual deficiencies and will be crying out to God for help.
I druga grupa koja će misliti da je dobra i da je spasitelj nije potreban.
And the other group who believe that they are good enough and they do not need a savior.
Prva opisana grupa mogla bi da se identifikuje sa stihom napisanim u Jevrejima 9. U Jeremiji 9. Poglavlju koji kaže 24. stihu, nego ko se hvali, neka se hvali tim što razume i poznaje mene.
And the first group could be identified by the words which are written in Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 24. But let him that glorieth glory in this, that he understandeth and knoweth me, that I am the Lord, that I am the Lord.
Također druga grupa mogla bi da se identifikuje sa stihom iz 2. Timotiju, citirajte na pamet, koja kaže ovako, koji imaju obličje pobožnosti, a sile su se odrekli.
And the second group, we can just recap the words from 2 Timothy, chapter 3, those who have the form of godliness, but deny the power thereof.
Možemo sebe da zapitamo sada, da li mi imamo tu silu sa nama?
So we can ask ourselves, do we have this power from heaven?
Da li smo se odrekli te sile, možda neko treba nas da se kloni po savjetu apostola Pavla?
Maybe we have forsaken that power and we need the advice like the Apostle Paul gave.
Da li gajimo taj odnos sa našim spasiteljem?
Do we nurture that relationship with our Savior?
Nisam ovo planirao da vam kažem, ali sad kad sam rekao gajimo, setio sam se jedne slike kako neko nešto da institucionalno.
Now, I wasn't planning to say this, but when we said the word nurture, I remembered something that I want to share with you now.
Moja supruga gaji orhideje.
My wife nurtures orchids.
Tako da ne samo da ih drži u kući ima kao cveće, nego ih gaji, ali sad ću ispričati kako ona to čini.
She doesn't just hold them in the house and but she actually nurtures them and I want to tell you how she does it.
Ona svako jutro dođe, proveri da li je važno sa saksijama dovoljno, dobra?
She every morning comes and has a look if there's enough moisture at the bottom of the sacks.
I to je taj tehnički deo.
That's the technical part.
A onda kreće onaj deo gajenja.
And then comes that moment or the phase of nurturing.
A to je deo gdje ona priđe svako je ti devi. I onda kaže, ti si jako lepa, ti jako lepo raste, sve tebe jako puno voli.
And then this is the moment where she approaches every orchid and says, you're so beautiful, you're developing so beautifully, and I love you so much.
I znate kako, i Mio i Danilo i ja se ponekad nastavimo sa njom dok ona priča sa svecem, ne sve razumete to?
And naturally my children Mio and Danilo, we have a little bit of fun sometimes when you see somebody is speaking to the clouds.
Ali stvar postaje ozbiljna kad još neke sestre i crkve svoje postaknule orhideje donesu Ani na gajenje.
But the situation becomes even more interesting when some women from church bring their orchids to Anna for her to nurture them.
Izgleda da u tom gajenju ili u tom gajenju lepog odnosa ipak ima da
se. It appears that through this kind of kindness and nurturing, there is something there.
Ako ste si mi sada možda onako možda i podubljivo nasmejali to, nemam ja ću vam dokazati naučno da to ima vrlo velike osnove.
And if you happen to laugh a little bit at this incident, I will show you scientifically, I will review it to you how it's possible.
E, ajde sad da se vratimo na pitanje. Da li mi gajimo naš odnos na našim spasiteljima?
Let's return back to the question now. Are we nurturing our relationship with our Savior?
Da li mu sa ljubavlju govorimo koliko ga volimo i koliko nam je stalo da nas On brani na tom sudu koji dolazi?
Do we talk to Him and tell Him how much we love Him and that He will be our representative on that judgment day?
Da li mu nekad kažemo, Isuse, koliko jedva čekam da te zagrlim kada budeš došao?
Do we tell Him, Jesus, I hardly can wait to hug you when you return?
Trebali bismo to da gradimo u ovo vreme dok još uvek nije na strani.
We should be nurturing this in this time while there is still time and mercy.
Da li možda nekad omalovažimo Isusa?
Maybe we defame Jesus or put Him down a little bit.
Hajde da vidimo koliko je vredao Hristov život.
Let's see how much value was there to Jesus' life.
Podsjetio bih vas da su anđeli ponudili svoj život samo da Hristos ne bi dao svoj.
I'll remind you that the angels offered to give their lives just so Jesus wouldn't have to give his.
Možda ću sad staviti jedan mali šok za sve vas, ali pogledajte ovo.
Maybe there's going to be a little bit of a shock for you, but have a look at this.
Ne znam da li ste znali da Jovan 3.16 upravo tvoj život stavio na kantar sa Isusovim životom.
Do you realize that John 3.16 has placed your life on the same weighing scales with Jesus' life?
Što znači, Isus je dao život za jednoga. Što znači da njegov život vredi kao život jednoga.
So that means that Jesus gave his life for one, and his life is worth the life of one.
To je jako lepa vez. Jer to našem životu, to mom i tvom životu, da je jako veliku vrednost.
This is wonderful news because that gives a lot of value to your and my life.
A to je tako velika istina da je Bog svemira dao svog sina za mene, mrvicu na ovoj planeti.
And what a wonderful truth that the God of all the universe gave his son for me, who am nothing on this earth.
I prihvatanjem te žrtve u stvari otkrivamo i prihvatamo radosnu vest da će posle ovog vremena nevolje doći ono lepo vreme koje mi u stvari čekamo.
And by receiving this wonderful news, we are encouraged and waiting in hope for that soon coming day when Jesus will return.
I ne samo mi da čekamo, nego su čekali svi od Adama, Eve, Kaina, Avelja, kroz cijelu istoriju, svi su čekali taj drugi Hristov dolazak.
And not just us waiting for the second coming of Christ, but all the way through from Adam and all the patriarchs and prophets through the ages to our day today.
A nije daleko, tu je blizu. Imamo priliku da gledamo događaje koji to već najavljuju. Šta bi apostol Pavle dao da može to da gleda svojim očima?
And really, it's not far. We are watching the last day's events unraveling before our eyes. What would apostle Paul give to be part of this time of Earth history?
Još nekoliko reći o nevolji koja dođe, imao bi neku moralnu obavezu da kažem i ovaj deo.
A couple more words about the evil which is coming. I have an obligation, moral obligation to share.
Pitak u duha proroštva s lice strane kaže, neka niko od vas ne traži u molitvi bezuslovno ozdravljenje za nekoga.
The spirit of prophecy tells us that none of us should ask for the healing of someone, unconditional healing of someone.
Nego da tražimo Božju volju,
but to seek God's will,
da li će nekom sačuvati život ili ne,
whether you, somebody's life will be saved or not,
jer može biti od večne vrednosti,
because this may be of eternal importance.
To piše u poglavlju koja se zove Mnogi će otići na počinje.
And this is a chapter with a heading which says Many will fall astray.
Ne znamo šta znači to mnogi, ali mnogi, uglavnom većina, kaže mnogi će otići na počinje.
And we don't know how many that is, many, but it suggests a majority will fall asleep.
I sad nešto što me prosto tenisao sam pripremao ovu propu je lupilo kao grom sa neba.
And while I was preparing for this presentation last week, something hit me like a storm out of heaven.
Kaže ovako, mnogi mališani će biti uzeti pred vreme nevolje.
It says that many small children will be taken before the stable time.
Upravo da ne prolaze strahotu koja dolazi.
So that they wouldn't have to go through the terrible things that are coming upon the earth.
Možda onima koji smrt gledaju tamo nešto nepoznato, strašno, opasno, njima ovaj citat može biti jako strašno. Međutim, nama koji znamo delo drugačije.
To those who are fearful of losing their life, this quotation would be very terrible for them. But for us it shouldn't be so.
Koliko je samo lepše ne spavati pa se probuditi kada je nevolja prošla.
How nice it is to fall asleep and wake up after the storm has passed.
I kada je sve gotovo.
And when everything is done.
Ima jedna pesma sekularna koja kaže probudi me kada sve ovo prođe.
There is a secular song which says wake me up when all this is gone.
I kad sam malo pametniji i malo mudriji za vreme tamo neko bolje koje dolazi.
And when I'm a little smarter and wiser for the time that is to come.
Hajde da kažemo ovako. Imamo problem, naše duhovno stanje može da se popravi.
Let's start like this. We have a problem. Our spiritual condition can be improved.
Vreme velike nevolje ne može da se zamisli koliko će biti strašno.
The time of the trouble, big trouble, cannot even be imagined what it will be like.
I Ellen White kaže, nekada kad zamislimo događaje kakvi će biti, onda mislimo, jao, bit će strašne, ali kaže, ove što dolaze, bit će mnogo strašne, što bilo ko može da zamisli.
And often we think in advance of the dangers and difficulties that have to come, but the mind is not able to, Ellen White says, understand or imagine the troubles that have to come.
Međutim, moram da kažem celu istinu, a to je da je u celo istorijsko razdoblje Boži mir bio sa onima koji su bili njemu verni.
But I have to tell the truth that throughout all history, those who were faithful to God had peace.
Boži narod u vreme potopa bio na sigurnom.
The children of God before the flood, they were assured.
Dok je ceo svet bio udavljen, verni su putali u čamcu, u tom brodu gde su bili svi.
And while the rest of the world drowned, they were floating on the water in the ark.
Dok su zmije u pustinji jedali, svi su umirali oni koji su verovali u Hrista, mogli su dobiju i bezenje.
And when the snakes were biting the Israelites in the desert, those who had faith and looked up, they received healing.
Sam Isus Hristos došao je da spase momke koji su gorali u vatri.
Jesus himself came to save people who were burning, his young lads who were burning in a fire.
I nešto zanimljivo, nekada je bilo bezbednije prespavati sa lavovima neko okružen vladarima Vavilonskog carstva.
And in a battle, you just think it would have been sometimes easier and safer to speak with a group of lions than with the dictators of the time.
Oni koji su bili sa Bogom uvijek su bili zaštićeni.
Those who were with God were always protected.
Možda nisu imali mir oko sebe, ali su imali mir unutar sebe.
Maybe there was no peace around them, but there was peace inside of them.
Možda ih je nešto bolelo, ali su imali mir unutar sebe.
Maybe there was some pain they were enduring, but they had peace inside themselves.
To nije mir koji možemo da donesemo meditacijom, jogom i drugim lažnim stvarima koje su sotonskog porekla.
We cannot bring this peace into our lives through meditation and yoga and all these satanic lies.
Posjetio bih vas da u Valdezanskim dolinama u Italiji nisu imali jogu da bi imali mir dok su bežali od Rimljana.
Nisu
jogu praktikovali te meditacije da bi imali mir.
The Valdezans, while they were running from the authorities in their days, did not perform meditation and yoga to help them.
Oni su imali molitvu i razgovor i proučavanje Svetoga pisma, druženje sa Isusom Hristom. To im je dalo mir u najnesigurnije vreme.
They had union with one another with the word of God and in prayer, and this gave them security.
Podsjetio bih vas da ni prvi ni drugi svjetski rat nije uspio da iskoreni veru iz srca ljudi koji su verovali.
I have to say that the first and the second world wars did not eradicate the faithful heart.
Moj pradeda pre 100 godina je propovedao sa propovedonicom u Turgu o skorom Hristovom dolasku.
My great grandfather 100 years ago preached sermon in Turug saying of the soon coming of Jesus Christ.
Nekim čudom papir je ostao sačuvan, imam kod sebe kući taj papir i čuvam ga.
By some miracle this piece of paper was saved and I have that at home with me.
Bio je u zatvoru zbog svoje vere.
He was in jail because of his faith.
Ali ostao veran.
But he did remain faithful.
Osjetim vas da ni građanski ratovi na Balkanu, našim zemljama, zemljama našeg porekla, nisu uspjeli da iskorene vam.
And even the wars that happened in former Yugoslavia on our territory didn't succeed in eradicating the faithful people.
Čitajući istoriju adventnog pokreta na našim prostorima, čak i ne vidim da nekada više crkva rasla, nego upravo za to vreme, kada je bila nevolja.
And looking at the history of the Advent people on our home ground, it never grew more than when there were troubles around them.
Sada na kraju želeo bih da uputim jedan poziv upravo tebi.
And now, for the end, I would like to make an appeal exactly to you.
Tebi koji možda misli da će doći neko lepše vreme, da trebamo da se nadamo nekom lepšem vremenu.
To you who thinks that better times are coming and we should look forward to these better times.
Nadajmo se lepšem.
Hope for the better.
Čekajmo bolje.
Wait for the better.
Ali kada Gospod dođe, nikako pre toga.
But only when Jesus comes, never before that.
Nemojmo govoriti ovlast, mir je, a mira u principu nema.
And let's not say wastefully, peace, peace, when there is no peace.
Budemo iskreni prema sebi i pogledajmo naše realno duhovno stanje, kakvo je danas, sada.
Be realistic with oneself and see what is my spiritual condition like right now, today.
Ako vidiš svoga komšiju da je daleko od Boga i da ne zna ovu lepu radost od Boga spasenja, nemoj čutati o tome da čovjek ima duhovni rak i da mu treba spasenje.
If you see your neighbor and you know that he is far from the truth of God and he needs salvation and a kind word, don't hesitate to share what God has given you.
Približimo se Bogu, a protivimo se đavolu.
Let's come closer to Jesus and God and let's distance ourselves from Satan.
I to bi trebalo da počne i danas i da se nastavi sutra i svaki dan u budućnosti.
This needs to start today and to be continued tomorrow and every day of our future.
Volio bih da Bog da svakome nas realnu sliku o tome kakvi smo mi i koliko nam je u stvari potrebno spasiti.
And I would like God to give us a true picture of the reality of who we individually are.
Volio bih da nam Gospod na ovom putu pomogne da budemo uspešni i da doživimo njegov dolazak sa osmehom.
To ask God that He would help us on this journey, that we may get there successfully with Him.